Okay. Back here now. Break these. Okay, so we figured out now. I forgot that's what I did the first time. Not sure to pass this part. I'm gonna drop it here. Okay. And the other one should be just as easy. Let's get to your side. Hopefully. But I'm not as close to that much. Like it's too- Oh shit! I forgot I can't even do that. Okay. Ah crap, I forgot I can't even do that. I have to do it when I'm under your shadow. Okay. Okay. Let's do this again. At least that's already there. There's the other one. Can't jump, I have to be on it already. I can't jump and then jump past traffic if I can do that. Okay, now I can do it. Just like that. Now, drop it here. Jump on this. And we go where this is gonna take us. Right here. Funny meet it. It's a little bit more harder and a little bit of a challenge. But I think I already have the idea of what I have to do here. I'm gonna start with pressing this button. Okay. Somewhere. That's not there. Still going on that. I can't exactly push it to find a way to go around it. Question is, oh, I know what to do. It's very simple, it's right there. Ah, fuck me. Christ. They brought me back all over here. Are you kidding me? Why you said that you're there already? I don't have to worry about as much. Let's go back to over there. Excuse me. What? I'm gonna figure out. I need to figure out how to do that one. I figured it out pretty much. That one's easier, actually. Now we're doing this again. There's one there. I was almost there. Is that was the same one? I think it was the same one. Yeah, it was. It's fine. I could do it again. Oh, right there. It's easier. Oh, down there. Okay!
As Phoenix traveled through the underworld, her thoughts turned toward her mother and father. Were they safe in Argos? Had they too been transformed?
Ford, a huge monster appears! It's ginormous, but Phoenix just laughed.
You mama, mother!
No!
So you want to dance, huh?
Oh! Oh, it's perfect!
The adorable monster was ever so playful. Everything she had prayed for to take her mind off her worries. It was a gift from Olympus she would treasure forever. Deep within her vulnerable, yet ever-expanding
heart. Ah, fine! Have it your way! Just don't make me vomit!
Phoenix faced the monster, ready. The monster attacked.
Whoa. I just died.
Little one.
Helen. We have so much to talk about.
Whoever or whatever you are, you don't scare me.
Wait, when the thief said this was Aeolus's jar, I thought it would be a jar with the God of Winds on it, not in it. This little thing can't contain the wind. That's impossible.
Ah!
thought you said you were preparing something.
Yeah, preparing for you to return. You got the wings?
Yes.
Hey,
not really good as new, but what is?
Something new?
You have the jar, right? Get ready to open it.
What is that?
You deceitful thief! You thought you could escape me?
You stole something from the thing?
I told you, it's a problem.
Tweet, delivery boy. You do not deserve the crown you were given.
We'll take you down, Typhon! Just like before!
We? There is no we! Not anymore!
Phoenix! No! Open your wings!
I can't!
I have you now!
Okay, we need to get to safety. Stat.
What was that monster?
Typhon.
Not the Typhon.
Oh, you have no idea. Gotta get to the Hall of the Gods, then we can talk. You ready to fly?
These were Daedalus's wings. The Daedalus? The great inventor?
So?
So they didn't work right and killed his son.
He'll be fine. Just don't fly too close to Helios. And also don't try to go to the bathroom during turbulence. You should make it to the mainland without crashing. Probably.
You literally robbed me, and now you're saving me. Why?
I didn't follow most of what the Oracle ran through. But if the prophecy is on the money, hero on high, you're the only one who can stop Typhon from remaking the world.
We don't even know if it's about me.
For someone trying to help everyone right and left, maybe you should accept help once in a while.
What are you talking about?
Fates alive! How is the Winged Herald supposed to provide aid when you won't let me?
With the Winged Herald's aid? Wait! Winged Herald? No way! You are...
Hermes! I like telling half-truths, playing tricks, and taking long runs on the beach. Now, can we go, please? The other gods need our help.
Other gods? You mean, all the stories are real?
Something's wrong with your face. It's doing that slack-jawed thing again. Fly to the Golden Isle. Meet me at the Hall of the Gods. I'll be waiting.
And with that, Hermes disappeared. Phoenix gazed across the narrow band of sea at the peaks and valleys of the Golden Isle ahead. The long path to her true destiny lay stretched out before her.
Wait! That was just a prologue? How does it take someone that long to begin a story? Odysseus made it home faster.
She's about to jump. Be quiet and listen.
wanted to go up there. Oh, come on. See your people in front.
Attack! Cleanse this world of divine imperfection!
The sight of the Great Hall took Phoenix's breath away.
This is incredible!
It's all right. Could use some updating. The Golem motif is a bit played out.
So, we're safe here.
Remember that thing I stole from Typhon? It was an itty-bitty piece of his eye to hide this place from his terrifying gaze. You're welcome.
You said this is the Hall of the Gods. Well, where are the others?
Let me start from the beginning.
With his hand on Phoenix's shoulder, Hermes recounted the tale of Typhon, destroyer of gods. Typhon, born of Gaia, was a terrible, cruel beast who vowed to free the Titans and obliterate the gods. He challenged Zeus for the rule of the cosmos. Fortunately, Typhon was defeated.
Damn straight he was!
And imprisoned under a mountain, where he could do no more harm.
I got to get back into that kind of shape again.
For thousands of years, Typhon festered, until Helios was eclipsed and burning stars fell from the heavens. The stars burnt through Typhon's chain, and in an explosion of fire and smoke, Typhon burst from the mountain. The gods had wronged and tortured him.
Never again!
He vowed.
This world will be cleansed. The gods will pay!
And so, Typhon sought his revenge.
Destroy the veil that separates this hallowed land from the underworld. Let Tartarus walk among the gods. Trample, devour, and turn this life false gods to dust. Come, Olympians, brandish your weapons and face me. You have underestimated my power and wag in your hubris. Bow to my unseekable perfection!
Some gods fled in fear. Others stayed to fight. Many were captured. Typhon split them apart, cleaving their essences from them and transforming them irrevocably. In a final, desperate attempt to save their lands, the gods called on the heroes of old. The last warriors who had more than a few drops of God's blood remaining in their veins.
Weak and selfish! Your heroes will exist as shadows of their former selves, serving me forever!
The gods had failed, and so had the heroes. But just when all hope seemed lost,
so yeah, a lot of fighting and losing. And now you are our only remaining hope to restore these lands to their former glory and save the world from chaos. All we have, Phoenix, is you. No pressure.
I kind of lost track of who's who. Is that one with the spiky hair you or Typhon?
Forget it. The vanquished gods need to be reunited with their severed essences to regain their power. And then, together, you must defeat Typhon.
This is honestly a lot. I wish my brother was here.
Look, kid, I'm not perfect. I'm the guy who escorted Pandora to Earth for Zeus's sake. But maybe, just maybe, you're the right hero at the right time. Also, you're literally all we've got, seeing as how everyone else has been defeated. Good luck! I'll be right here, doing nothing. I mean, beginning preparations.
Thanks. I think.
Oh, there's that face again. Fine. Your best starting point is to reach the top of the other statues on the Golden Isle, so you can track the missing gods. Find them, and they should be able to help you locate their stolen essences. Although, they haven't been themselves, so I'm really not sure.
What's that mean?
Guess you'll find out.
Phoenix think? What would my brother do? Ligiron would probably take on Typhon single-handedly, like when he bested the entire Spartan fleet. Who am I kidding? I'm in way over my head.
Phoenix stumbled upon a winged creature, easily mistaken for a fairy. However, as Phoenix freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle, she let out a cry, which meant, "Great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory."
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. So, what is it?
Phoenix would need to free it to find out.
Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pacing?
Thank you.
was that?
Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. The Hall of the Gods. Eros's Palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the Goddess of Beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a fluttering of birds, feeding from the most beautiful apple tree, caught Phoenix's eye.
Phoenix was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes, that view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!
Tell me the deeds of Golden Aphrodite, who subdues mortal men and birds in air, and the creatures on land and sea. Grant me a song. Stir up my sweetest passions.
Hey, watch it, buddy. That's my daughter-in-law you're talking about.
Instrument knew he wasn't watching me. Yeah, funny beat the pro was in. I'm here now. We came on one friend to take a break, and I'm gonna be back on again tonight.
Suddenly, the majestic form of a wild
I don't know him talk. Oh, good. Stop him soon, I'm gonna take a nap.
You wouldn't happen to be Aphrodite?
Why, yes, I am. Pleasure to humbly make your acquaintance.
Phoenix! Sorry, I'm just such a fan. You're responsible for some of the most epic love stories of all time. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting a tree, but even in your, arboreal state, you're beautiful.
Oh, that's sweet of you to say, but the only mirror I gaze into these days reflects the happy smiles of the creatures I help. Oh, if only I could travel to those most in need. But, alas, my roots keep me anchored here.
So that's why Typhon did this to you. So you can't use your beauty to move ships or inspire bravery in battle against him.
Me? Start a war? I don't know where you get such outlandish ideas. True beauty is found in acts of service. True love is the giving of yourself to others. The name Aphrodite should have stood for those things all along.
She did not just say that.
I am reformed now. My old essence locked away in a vault, wedged under my largest root. Which is for the best.
Maybe I could get that essence back for you. I'm going to need allies to go up against Typhon.
We have the hungry to think about.
You said you need to free yourself from your roots. To feed the hungry, of course. Well, my roots were as a pretty bad farmer. So I know how to hurt plants. Salt. It shrivels them up.
Oh, would that work? But of course, my roots are not ordinary. They're primal. Powerful.
So we'll need, mythical salt water? Oh. Oh! This is in the prophecy! A pearl in rough seas! You were a pearl born from rough seas! The salty seafoam from your birth!
Yes! What an inspired proposal! But I couldn't possibly trouble a stranger to recreate the conditions of my birth.
What if a stranger asked to be troubled?
If a stranger asked to be troubled, then I suppose I wouldn't really be troubling them at all. Here's how to conjure seafoam from my birthplace.
I already know all about this. Mom loved this story. Grandpappy Uranus threw a pearl into the sea. The sea churned into foam, and Aphrodite rose up out of it.
A pearl, Grandpappy? I'm not sure that's how it...
That's definitely the story.
Okay. I'm sure that's how it went, down.
Got it. Knock a pearl into the ocean really hard. That sounds simple enough.
Oh, thank you, Phoenix. I'll be serving fresh apples to the less fortunate across the Golden Isle in no time.
Why are you whispering?
Because I don't want to scare it away.
What are you on? Because can I have some? Well, this is weirder than the time Demeter turned that kid into a lizard. Aphrodite, sweet and charitable. No more mischief.
Isn't that what you were aiming for when you married her off to Hephaestus against her will?
Hey now, it wasn't. I mean, she knew I was doing it for our own good.
I'm gonna stop here. Okay, again tonight later.